Richard Vincent Weber, Colonel.
You must be the city boy.
Still awake, Colonel.
Aim for the faint of heart. Make real courage and stand there as a man.
How long have you been in manuscript, Colonel?
Oh, 3-4 years. The only soldiers need a quiet place to feel at home after the war. So she lets me stay in exchange of, well, I keep telling stories of some of my wives to him.
Right. Tell me, Colonel, in those 3-4 years, ever seen this pretty girl here?
Digging for ghosts, city boy.
What the hell are you talking about, old man?
I'm talking about the girl. Dead. How'd you come about this, bitch?
Dead girl? I don't know. It was on my desk.
Well, she was killed right here. Right here. Right now. Nanny, tell me not to talk about it anymore. It's one of the few things that dampen the infectious smile. But I tell you, see us over late and nobody's around. She went downstairs to find her husband, but he wasn't alone. And she got there. A girl sucking on his petticoat in the middle of the kitchen. Can you imagine the audacity of son of a bitch getting his picker sucked in the middle of the place with strangers? Wife, she takes a knife to the husband, cut. But the husband overpowers her, strong and burly and drunk as he is. He snatches the knife from her and he slides to her. Right across the knee, right in. Shot bullets. Dumped in the sea. At least, well. Just a legend. Just don't tell Nanny, or else I'm gonna have to kill you, you know. Why this certain fear in your eyes, kid? They're just ghost stories after all.
Because I dreamt of the girl in the photograph. He was seducing me, tied me up to the bed and stabbed me with a dirty knife.
No reason. That ghost got to be mad at you for, huh? For anything else badly done, kid. Anger got the best of you. Bye! Some dreams ain't worth it.